Another one, Buster Dust. Oh, you're here. How exciting. You missed me? I missed me. I was away. Where was I? I went into the world of finishing the bloody book I'm writing. Because sometimes you have to take time out, focus, and do what you have to do. And I am a person with a lot of ideas, and I create many things, and I can be all over the place, which is lovely, but not very good for finishing projects. So I had this few weeks of finishing my book. Today is my last writing day. From tomorrow, I'm going to be editing it with somebody amazing. But I have to say that writing this book, if you know me, you hear me saying that for many, many years. The book started very different. It started as a show. I thought I was writing a show. I was writing a performance with acts, and this happened because I'm a very visual, theatrical person. But then became script that I went like, okay, they need to create it much more clear. And then I wrote it into a story, which was kind of a tale, kind of a symbolic book, maybe a children's book, maybe, you know, kind of simple little book. But it expanded. It expanded because I grew. And now, after all these years, I was finishing it. And that means that a lot of things were coming up, things that are connected to the fact that I'm healing myself and healing my ancestry and understanding some of the things that were going on in the last 1,000 years. Yes, some of us are busy with some stuff because there is a big shift in how humans are taking their power, how we are remembering who we are, how we're revealing the truth and going beyond the veil. So, yeah. So I had a lot of pain in my body, as I wrote in my last newsletter, my last blog. My body was going through purge while I was writing and realizing, and I'm still realizing. And this book is a first of a trilogy. How do you say that in English? Anyway, three books. So a lot is going on. So I invite you into my new desk, which can probably look like a mess for a person that has a much more office place, so much better organized. But I like it creative. I like it. I like to be surrounded. I have jewelry in front of me. I have costumes. Crazy. Anyway, what I wish for myself is that I will be able to finish this book and bring it to you. And then my next performances would come as a project that I separate, so I'm not going to drive myself nuts. That will come in the autumn. And my Happy Godessa new designs, you know, I have new designs that also will come out. And that I can be at peace with the fact that I live in wonderful chaos. Chaos but growth. And love, which is the conclusion of everything. Being in vibration of higher consciousness, being a vibration of gratitude, being a vibration of love and joy, which is, as King Solomon was telling me while I was channeling him for my book, that's the biggest purpose of life, to be able to stay in that frequency. That's what's all about. So, and of course, the union. The union between the queen and the king of heaven, of ourselves, inside ourselves, in our biological parents, all of this sacred marriage and the healing all of it is so important and so profound. So I didn't mean to make a video, but just it started to play by itself. So I'm talking to you, and I'm going to go live. Somebody asked me, can you do something for 8th of August? And I thought I was not prepared. And then I remembered, start before you're ready. So we're going to do that. We're going to have a meditation. So I invite you to join us to 8-8 Lion Gates meditation. And I'm going to bring some of my new guides Oh my God, am I gonna do that? I'm gonna make it a public knowledge. I have to see about that. All the old fear of persecution are coming up. Anyway, there's amazing energy. There's amazing energy in the world, and some of it is very brutal and very scary, but that's the part that is kind of getting separate itself from the evolved part. You know, there is a stronger consciousness that's emerging that is full of light and compassion and collaboration and unity between masculine and feminine. So you choose which boat you're going. You're staying with the old boat or you're going with a new boat. Are you connecting to your heart and finding your own connection to source, or are you staying with the old same old controlling stuff and old and pretty low vibration of confusion and doubt and anger and unresolved trauma? But if you do choose to stay with the old trauma, it's all right, because we are in a planet of free choice. As a soul, if that's what you want to experience, you can do that. You can have another lifetime of killing, being killed, until your heart content. The only thing is that the planet Earth is leaving this program. So if you want to do this kind of lifetimes, no judgment, it will be available somewhere else. So this is what's going on. This is the bloody ascension we all talk about. It's exciting, it's scary, and it is totally revolutionary. But it's worth it. I can tell you, it's worth it. There is nothing better than to fill up your mind and your heart and your body and your spirit with the light of the unconditional love creation. You go like, why didn't I do it before? Because before, sometimes we were busy investigating what is dark, what is light. That's the whole game on this planet. And sometimes you feel, okay, I had enough of this. I want to expand light. I want to do this. So if you're one of those people, hey, you're my tribe. Love you guys. So this is my spontaneous video. I don't know if even if I'm gonna post it. But it's recorded, so let's do it. Love you very much. Stay tuned this August. Stay connected. Go to nature. If you're on vacation, wonderful. I cannot go anywhere, so I'm staying here. But nature is also here. Earth is also here. The sun is also here. The air is here. The water are here. The elements, all of them are inside of you. And connecting to your own inner voice and your own connection brings you immediately to the right energy. Doesn't matter where you are. So this is what I wanted to say. Is there something I want to show? Yes. This is the message. Can you see it? Oh, I think it's double. It says anything that costs your peace is too expensive. So peace, creation, love, and working out the shadows. You know, those happiness and love and all the great stuff doesn't happen by itself. You have to find a way how on a regular basis to release some of the old traumas and pain and everything. So very enjoying talking to you. I hope it was not too much. And look at the new necklace that I made. I love this color. I'm now into this color. And of course, when you're going up, I want another thing I want to say. When you're changing your frequency and you're going elevating yourself, what happens, which I wish somebody told me, is that you're getting new guides. Yes, it changes. So it changes that you get new guides. Guides that you didn't have access to before when you were in that frequency. And with new guides and with new consciousness comes also colors. There are different shades of different colors that can be a very good indication to who you're working with. So life is so magical, so magical, so magical. I want you to be tuned into it. And it starts with a connection to your inner voice, to your soul voice, to your wonderful things. Anyway, so as you can see, I didn't talk to people for a long time because I'm just writing my book. So this is came out and I was just babbling for 10 minutes straight. But I'm getting ready for the Lion's Gate. And you too. And all the blessings coming to you too, because I like to share. Bye. See you soon.